This program is brought to you in part by the Freedom Forum, a nonpartisan foundation dedicated to free press, free speech, and free spirit for all people.
Was a kind of hero, unsung hero.
All of the civil rights movement of Florida stands largely on the shoulders of Harry T. Moore.
He was so far ahead of his time. His political organizing was way beyond anything that was happening in the South. It could have changed the state of Florida, it could have changed the civil rights movement, and that's why he was killed.
In the early 20th century, Florida beckoned people to a tropical paradise. But for most settlers, Florida was anything but paradise. It was a hardscrabble life. Annual income was half the national average. Most children attended school only 2 months a year. And if you were black, conditions were much worse. Black laborers and sharecroppers did backbreaking work for below living wages. It was, after all, a white man's world. Florida coon cards or postcards from early in the century reminded blacks of their place in society. Florida politicians reminded them as well. In 1916, Florida elected Sidney Katz governor. A former Baptist preacher, Katz had found a new and bigger pulpit. He warned about demon alcohol, Jews, papists, and Negroes. He campaigned against any public schooling for blacks, saying, "The Negro is an inferior race. I do not believe in higher education for Negroes when there are thousands of white children who get only 2 or 3 months of schooling."
The teens, when people like Sidney J. Katz, the racist, anti-Semitic governor, come along, he begins railing against blacks as part of his platform. And one of the outgrowths is that blacks begin migrating out of the state.
In the first half of this century, close to 2 million blacks in the Deep South made their way north.
Tens of thousands of black families left the state of Florida during the Great Migration to escape the violence of the Klan, the poverty, and the stranglehold of the sharecropping system. And for some reason, Harry Moore's family stayed.
Harry Tyson Moore was born in 1905 in Houston, Florida, not far from the banks of the Suwannee.